Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to frontstretch.com in the cockpit with Mike Massie, up and coming iRacing superstar. He's been participating in the weekly Monday night races. It started out as a media deal, but it's gone much beyond that. And pretty much the talent pool in this thing is exceptional. We're going to start checking in on Mike. Mike, I know that you've dominated in the iRacing street stock days. Now you've moved up to this next level, and it's been so rumored that you were coming into it that William Byron and Timmy Hill weren't even about to get into these races. So can you give us a little idea of just how successful you were coming up through the ranks in the iRacing series?
Let me tell you about everything I've won coming up, all right? You mentioned I've won street stocks, all right? I won more street stocks, and that's all I had to do. Because Richard Petty, only won in the Cup Series. Neil Armstrong, only landed on the moon. Did they have to do anything more? Did people question them after that?
So apparently not. And that's good enough to get you into this series. Now, I know iRacing has a little different laws of physics than the world does. And we've seen multiple instances of drivers getting a little airborne when contact has occurred on a racetrack. What do you judge your highest altitude to be from a iRacing wreck?
Well, let's just say, you know the song Somewhere Over the Rainbow? That was written after one of my iRacing crashes. You know the TV show Lost in Space? That was also written after one of my iRacing crashes.
Someday I crash my iRacing car way up where the clouds are far behind me.
So that should tell you everything you need to know right there.
I understand that. I know one of the benefits of iRacing is the ability to just regenerate your car after an incident, which I'm sure has been helpful to you because the Over the Rainbow one actually caused your car to burn up on re-entry from the atmosphere. So that's a pretty nice advantage of the iRacing world where you can reset it once you've had a wreck.
The car regenerates, but the emotional scars never heal.
No, no, not again, no!
I can imagine that's something you have to work hard to overcome. Speaking of overcoming adversity, I know in the summertime especially, these races can be exhausting to the drivers. We've seen it in the Cup Series with 130, 140 degrees in a car. When you're iRacing and that CPU is broiling hot, how do you deal with trying to keep it cool and better yet, keep yourself cool?
Yeah, it is hard with, you know, keeping the air conditioning in the apartment at 72 degrees. This thing is burning up, and sometimes it cuts off randomly from doing it. So the cure to it, you got to take a tray of ice cubes, you lay that on top of the tower, the computer, and as those melt and sink down into the wires and all that stuff, it cools it down. That's really good for technology, too, to put water on it.
I have no doubt that people don't realize if you put water on electronics, it will actually make them function at a higher level.
Here's a look at my rig. As you can see, there is one glaring issue. It's got a brake pedal. And all the brake pedal ever does is slow you down. So I'm getting that thing removed.
So in your experiences so far on iRacing, both with the Monday night shows, but better yet in your street stock days, what did you find was your best track?
The best track was probably Oxford Plains, because there, if you spin out, you just keep spinning out and you do a whole lap like that. So you kind of do a burnout, and that's how you end up winning the race.
That is phenomenal. I bet that's something that Hill and Byron have never even attempted, because it takes a certain skill level to be able to do a burnout for an entire lap.
Yeah, you know what? Hill, Byron, they're scared of me. They're scared of our league. That's why they haven't gotten in it yet. William Byron, you and me, Monday night, Oxford Plains, IndyCar, it's on.
I like how you think, my friend. Now, I know that the season has been a build-up to this last regular season race before the playoffs, and you haven't wanted to intimidate everybody too bad, so your average finish is somewhere back there around 12th. Is it time to finally flip that switch and come in with a dominating victory so you make it on into the playoffs?
That's right. That's right. You got to just hang back. You got to sandbag, you know, and that way you can get that whole steam of momentum coming. I'm going to win that last race. Yeah, I've just been hustling them this whole time. Now that the big money's on the line, I'm going to come out there and I'm going to lap the field and win for the pole, lead every lap. and still finished 12th.
Die, you rebel scum!
Well, no. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Mike Massie is prepared to put a whipping on them Monday night. You need to tune in and watch it because you will not believe what happens unless you see it with your own eyes. Mike, do you have any parting shots for your competitors, or better yet, knowledge for the fans that you want to impart?
Well, I want to tell them a little about the pre-race ritual that I do every week.
I know drivers have different superstitions, and you have some special ones. So please let us know what you do before you take to the track.
So you know, in NASCAR, a big part of the pre-race is the invocation. I do a different type of invocation for iRacing. I pray to the internet gods and say, oh, sweet Xfinity, just get me through one more race. And it doesn't get you through that one more race, but I don't know. It's just a good thing to do. The other pre-race ritual I like to do is to eat Spam, because it just really settles the stomach. Spam, it's better for you than vegetables. Spam.
I smell what you are cooking, my friend. So, ladies and gentlemen, please make sure you tune in Monday night. Mike Massie prepared to put a whooping on the media folks and any other NASCAR guys that dare to have the big enough balls to come in and run against him. Mike, thank you for your time. We wish you the best. And we'll do a post-race interview next week to analyze your victory in this Monday night's race.